Previously, in our tests on segmented versus non-segmented ammo from CCI, I told you that you could shoot CCI 0074 and 0056 interchangeably up to 200 yards. Well, I thought that the experiments were over with segmented versus non-segmented, and then I was reminded, no, actually, there's Quiet 22. So we're going to begin a series of tests using segmented Quiet 22 versus Quiet 22. And those tests are coming up next on Mostly 22 LR. Hey everybody, Rob Rosenberger here for Mostly 22 LR. CCI makes a really interesting round called the Quiet 22, and they now have a segmented version of that round. As you know, the segmented version will split into three equal parts, or segments, and they'll tumble through a soft target, creating three separate wound channels. It's a devastating round on small game. But how is its performance on, let's say, at 710 feet per second, as Quiet 22 is? We'll go ahead and do a couple of experiments. Today we're only going to be focusing on whether or not they can meet the same bullet trajectory. And CCI can't really make this claim that the bullets are identical in their trajectories, because if you look carefully at the data that they offer on their website, you'll see that one of them at 25 yards is 1 foot per second slower than the other one, and it holds at 1 foot per second for the entire time that it goes out, at least to 100 yards. So what we're going to do is we're going to do the same kind of experiment that we did with CCI 0056 and 0074, which are basically the same rounds except they fly at 10 feet per second. We're going to test it to see how far we can get out here and get them to hold identical trajectories. They might not, but let's find out. Okay, so first up is CCI 960. That's their regular Quiet 22 round. It's a 40 grain round nose, and it's traveling at 710 feet per second. We'll take 10 shots and then switch up to the other ammo. Okay, now for 10 shots at 10 yards with CCI 970. That's their segmented Quiet 22. Okay, so laser rangefinder, 10 yards. These two do seem to have the same point of impact. Notice here that 970, which is the segmented round, seems to open up a little bit and seems to string. This might not be a problem here. This might be from the wind. You'll probably see that this is just a little bit off. However, I'm going to declare that I'm feeling confident that if I were to use this to shoot small game at 10 yards, I could shoot 960, which is just the Quiet 22, zero my rifle, and then take 970, which is the segmented, and just arbitrarily use that at 10 yards. It's an interesting stringing, and I think I've seen this before with Quiet 22. Interesting. And heartbeats would generally be pushing me this way. There's no alibis that I can call on me. Let's go ahead and shoot the next one. Okay, so we're going to shoot CCI 970. That's the segmented Quiet 22. And again, we're going to hit dead center on the very tip of this black line right up here. So in the next one, let's go to 40 yards, 40, and this time, since we're shooting a little bit left, which could simply be because I'm not shooting a suppressor, we'll go ahead and shoot dead center on the edge on the right side here for each one. So let's go to 40 yards. Okay, so when we look at these, we look at the Quiet 22 versus the segmented 22, what I think is happening here is I think that there's a rise. Notice here I'm shooting dead center here, and my center is somewhere right around here, whereas when we're looking here, my center is up in this area here. Now it's interesting that the segmented version has started to close up a little bit, whereas this one started to expand a little bit. So I'm not sure what to exactly make of that. It could just simply be, I don't know what it could be, the wind or something. But we're seeing here that this one is still holding a higher trajectory than this one for whatever reason. At 40 yards, I just don't think that you could zero with CCI 960 and then arbitrarily shoot 970. Now let's go ahead and look at 25 yards. At 25 yards, with the stringing and whatnot, we've got a group here, we got a tiny little group here, we got a tiny little group here. It's an interesting string, and we're somewhere right around here. We're somewhere at about the half inch mark inside this zone. And when we look here, we are even higher above that. So it looks to be about 1 inch high here at the 25 yard mark, and it looks to be about 1.5 inches high at the 40 yard mark. That's just doing it literally by measuring with my pinky finger. So if you're going to shoot at 10 yards or less, and you've got CCI 960, which is their traditional Quiet 22, and you want to arbitrarily put in a 970, go ahead, you're going to get your shot. If you're going out to 25 yards, just understand that you're going to be shooting at a different point of aim. And at 40 yards, you're definitely going to be at a different point of aim. So at 25 and 40, I would not say that that you should be shooting just arbitrarily with your point of aim for 960 and 960 and getting the same point of impact for 970. 10 yards or less, you're good for it. I'm Rob Rosenberger for Mostly 22LR. And remember, 22LR is real ammunition. Treat it as such. And for those who wonder if the ammo is getting cooked in the heat or if the barrel is getting hot from the sunlight, the answer is no. As you can see here, I'm undercover. So that's not what the problem is. That's not why these guys are opening up. And it's only about 75 degrees here. There is some interesting wind that's coming from lots of different directions. But as you can see from the flag right at the moment, we're not seeing any wind at all. A little bit right now. So nothing much. But those little gusts are coming up.